IVM.
We would like to thank Storytel for sponsoring this show. Storytel is an audiobook platform that lets you hear hundreds of thousands of stories on your PC, mobile, wherever you prefer. You can get a great deal for IVM listeners at storytel.com/IVM. This week, I'm going to recommend The Ivory Throne by Manu Pillai. This is a book about the history of Kerala. Manu's an incredible writer and helps you truly understand the history of the region. I first heard him talk about this book on the Filter Coffee podcast with Karthik Natarajan, and I couldn't wait to dive into this one after I heard that conversation. So, how do you get this book? Go to storytel.com/IVM, and what you'll do is, when you sign up over there, instead of $2.99, you'll get your first month for 99 rupees. So you get 200 bucks off on your first month. Go to storytel.com/IVM and go check out The Ivory Throne by Manu Pillai. Great book.
Welcome to Football Shootball episode 19. And by my voice, you know I'm sad. And also this episode is called Pyar Ke Side Effects. Because when you love, there is less happiness, more sorrow. Which is also same when you start loving certain football clubs.
Why are you sad, but?
I am sad because I'm not an Arsenal fan and I'm not used to disappointments over the last few months.
You're used to hiding under the bed, na? So nothing can get you. Neither love nor sorrow. Only Sheffield United strikers can get there.
Right. But within all of this sorrow, this is one question that I have. Is Shivram and I, who are sad because our teams didn't perform, forget did win or lose, just didn't perform. Or is it Ayer, who thought his team is performing and they actually scored a couple of goals, and then a team called West Brom took those 3 points away from them?
I'll tell you what, if I can interrupt you there, okay? I'm not as sad about Fulham as I, for some reason, I'm about Spurs, yeah? I think y'all have now made me feel something for Tottenham. Just because I said they'll win the league.
We made you feel something for the team you said will win the league.
Yeah, but you remember you said Chelsea win the league and you don't give a shit about Chelsea.
I don't. I just say stuff all the time. Like I say, surprise jokes are good, right? I don't mean it.
Chelsea has a weird conundrum altogether, right? They were hoping under Tuchel, this firepower attack that they have, you know, will finally show the world what they're capable of. But then they have to get an old 30-year-old captain at right back who ends up scoring a goal. And the second goal is scored by a guy who hasn't played for them for the longest time. But Spurs, yeah, I don't really care because they have no fans. So I can't go out and see sad Spurs fans. I can't see sad Fulham fans also till I met you, Karthik.
There are a lot of Spurs fans actually. Clearly a lot of people who've given up. They are like official clubs and everything. Like even Fulham doesn't have that and they do. I mean no disrespect to the senior vice executive chairman of the Fulham Club of India who was on this podcast with us.
Enough about sad Spurs fans and sad Fulham fans, oxymoron. Let's move on. It's called Pyar Ke Side Effects. We were sad, but we are not anymore because we have something to look forward to, which is what we've been telling us for the past, Shiva's for the longest time, I think over 10, 15 years now. As a United fan, I've been saying this since 2013. But the only happy thing about this week was I saw two of the great United players fight it out in the Milan derby. And Ayer will tell us more about what they actually said and why was Lukaku so hurt looking at this samurai hairstyle wala guy called Zlatan Ibrahimovic. But Amit has more important news to tell us before that. So we'll quickly get into a break and come back on the other side.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and LinkedIn, too, for that matter. And we've been putting up some content on LinkedIn, so do check that out. I'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, Storytel and The Whole Truth Foods. Thank you for supporting us. So, great week on the network again this week. Definitely do check out the Pragati Podcast. Pavan spoke to Krish Ashok. They discussed science, knowledge, and the wonder of Indian home cooking. Staying in the realm of food, on This Round Is On Me, we had A.D. Singh as a guest. Gauri and A.D. discussed the 10-year anniversary of The Table and the 20-year anniversary of Olive. So two of Bombay's biggest restaurateurs have a conversation about the restaurant business. All Things Policy celebrated 500 episodes on January 27th. Manoj talks to Aditya and Anirudh about the surprising origins of the podcast, its evolution over the last few years, and its exciting future. This episode also marks their video debut, so definitely do check that out on YouTube. On Storytellers and Storysellers, Vineet talks to Ranjit Pratap Singh. Ranjit is the co-founder and CEO of Pratilipi. Pratilipi is a company that's recently acquired IVM, and Ranjit on this episode discusses his plans to build a homegrown media empire, his love for comics, and how India can have its own comic cinematic universe. And finally, Cyrus had an exciting week. We had some amazing guests this week. We had Vishal Gundal come and talk about Fauji. We had Atish Tathir talk about the various issues that he had been facing with his OCI card and other things like that. We had Adam Dow talk about things going on in the US and, like, you know, the evolution of what's happening there. We had Siddharth Karan come and talk about his history with Cyrus and his new show. So definitely do come check that out as well. And with that, let me take you back to your show.
Okay, let's get this out of the way first. What really went down between Zlatan and Lukaku?
So it was the Coppa Italia, the quarterfinals, if I'm not mistaken. These two former United teammates, they square up. And if you know Lukaku, you know he does not really get riled up very easily. He's usually very calm. And Zlatan's more of the hothead, and Zlatan gets angry pretty easily. But Zlatan did say something, and I think we could all hear it, to Lukaku. And that really upset Lukaku. I think he referenced Lukaku's mother. And
referenced?
Then
I've never heard that word being used.
Dream
of
fornication.
Oh my God.
Yeah, but he said that he wants to do the dirty deeds to both Lukaku and his mother. So I really don't know where Zlatan was coming from there.
But Lukaku came back with a great comeback.
What did he say?
He said, "You and your wife." I have never heard that one before.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I guess anger brings the best out of Lukaku. But there was another couple of unsavory things said. There was an accusation of racism against Zlatan, it must be said, for using the term voodoo. But it must also be said that this reference comes to a story that was there a long ago that was reported, I think, in The Guardian many years ago, where the Everton owner said that some voodoo priest told Lukaku not to re-sign with Everton and join Chelsea. Lukaku has completely quashed that story. So let's not believe it. But I think Zlatan was making a reference to that story. But yeah, it was a fun fight. Zlatan has got himself a one-game ban. It didn't stop both the Milan sides from winning over the weekend, and the title race is just going down to the wire.
That's good. But I think as a player, the two people I don't want to see getting into a fight are Zlatan and Lukaku.
You wouldn't pay money for that. That's pay-per-view quality. We had the Royal Rumble this morning that we're recording. I would have rather watched Zlatan v. Ibrahimovic than that. I woke up at 5 a.m. Man.
Yeah, actually, it would be a good spectacle. You're right.
It would. I mean, nowadays, everyone's getting into boxing, right, Shivram? There's Jake Paul and I don't know who are all your YouTube followers.
Very nice. Yeah? Very nice, Karthik. Now, that is a good reference.
Yeah, aren't they? But they are, right?
They are. KSI has prime. I think his primary job is now boxing, and so is the Paul brothers. You're right.
Apparently, now this is again, I do not know. This could be just hearsay, but so what happened was boxing's popularity was falling big time because they didn't really have superstars from when we used to at least hear of them, like a Mike Tyson or a Lennox Lewis or even before that a Muhammad Ali. Now you have a few good ones, but I mean, like an Anthony Joshua is too cookie cutter to be a superstar. So what boxing did was went and told these YouTubers fight and get promotion for our sports. I think that's an extremely smart tactic.
I think it happened the other way around. Like, these two YouTubers basically were trash talking each other. They had like a boxing matchup. And then eventually, I think boxing arrived on the fact that, oh, wait, these guys are legit. Like, they're not just fighting for the sake of YouTube views. They're actually fighting. Like, it was a legit fight. And I think Jake Paul and KSI fought. And they've since then started riding on the wave when the first time it happened. And it's clearly done really well for both, I mean, YouTubers and boxing matches.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the boxing Royal Rumble on Republic Day that happened in Delhi. So that was good entertainment for a lot of people who were just watching.
I think you see Twitter accounts are being withheld. I mean, if you could withhold your jokes, that would be nice.
No, but I just also let's quickly brush it off because Karthik spoke about top of the table, down to the wire. Let's go to La Liga. There's nothing of that sort happening. Atletico are just going to run away with the...
Your Atletico, that you're extremely pleased with it. What are they? We were looking at it that day, right? Separate 10 points and 2 games in hand ahead over both Real and...
Yeah, some 7 or 10 points ahead. And the new Zidane campaign will come on Twitter very soon, sacking him. So Lampard still could get a job. Who knows?
Lampard at Real Madrid.
Yeah, he wants to play with kids anyway, right? So, I mean, that's the challenge that Madrid have right now. They're extending Luka Modric's contract.
Hazard has scored how many goals since he moved to Real Madrid?
Oh, now he will be waiting for Lampard to come. See what will happen. Okay. But let's talk about Premier League, where it's actually heating up. Almost everybody didn't get points apart from City, who obviously got points, and Liverpool now. So the top four is still the same. Maybe, I don't know, Liverpool is still fourth, Shiva? Or have they gone third after Leicester lost
to... Liverpool, I think, were third. And Leicester were fourth and West Ham are fifth. City and United are 1 and 2. But what is disappointing is City are not dispatching teams. Like, in the middle, they hit, like, form for a couple of games and then they went back to that 1-0.
Look, Sheffield is a difficult, you know, team to play against. Right? So it's not very easy to score against.
Are you... You should join Greenpeace, man. You recycle your jokes way more than they recycle.
But sad day for FPL.
That is why Shivram's a little salty, I feel. I mean, now we're complaining about City not dispatching, although because now they're 4 points ahead and a game in hand or something of that sort. I think y'all are just salty because, what do you call it? Pep Roulet,
yeah? Yeah, Pep Roulet, yeah. Like, everyone in my team was basically on the bench.
Yeah.
That is my major problem. But I'm really happy that I didn't take Mane, for whatever it's worth. I mean, at least these guys were in the squad. He was at home.
But yeah, we didn't know that he was hurt, right? I don't know what has happened to him.
Like, he had like a muscle injury the game before, I think, against Spurs, where he must have pulled a finger injury, pointing it at Jose.
I heard Klopp hugged him too tight, so maybe that could have happened. Seeing him dispatch Spurs away.
Okay, maybe Greenpeace also won't take you.
Greenpeace also won't take my jokes anymore.
But, I mean, talking of top of the table clashes, Sapre, enlighten us with your tricks and of the trade of FPL. What is happening? Where are you?
Are we moving to FPL already? Okay, now I'm happy because I'm doing well there. So yeah, I got 58 points, which is not great, above average.
Oh my god, the benchmarks have shifted.
Benchmarks have shifted suddenly. It's not very nice. At least for me, they've shifted.
Very nice.
Son didn't perform, who was my captain. I thought I'll get him as a differential because a lot of people had Cancelo as captain and Gundogan as captain. Some people captain Sterling, people that we know. I captained Son, who didn't get a chance to do anything. And the good thing about the game was Brighton didn't even have to sit back, park the bus to win against the Spurs team, right? They did. They played the way they do. And we spoke about this, right? They always have a good way of playing. They attack quickly, but they just don't score the goals that they deserve. Plus, we also spoke about Mopy being an asshole, which he also was in this match. He didn't do too much. He missed a good chance also.
I've made many mistakes in my life. I remember in 2008, I actually had stock in my account with a positive number staring at me, and I didn't sell it in time, and then basically it crashed. But what is my biggest decision that turned out right was sleeping at 12:30 last night, because I didn't have to end up watching that game. Why did you guys even watch it? I mean,
Brighton, I didn't. I was asleep as well.
Oh yeah, you had other engagements in the morning.
Yeah, I had to watch the Royal Rumble. Yeah, I stayed up for Barcelona Athletic Bilbao at least.
Yeah, Sapre, you watched it.
I watched it because I had Captain Son and I was hoping that, you know, he plays well.
But is there a connection between like people who pick a certain player and watch that game and then that game and then that player getting more points than he would normally have? Is there like a proven correlation, causation?
You're basically saying good vibes. If you can give good vibes at the screen.
This is pretty much that, right? So I'm just trying to get
I know Lukaku squashed voodoo shit, but you're doing voodoo shit.
I'm just trying to understand why you would watch Brighton play Tottenham.
I'd love to look at the data to answer your question. No, the only reason I saw was, one, A, I was disappointed that Son didn't do well. The other thing happened as expected is Bale sucked. Like, he really was extremely poor.
Mourinho also left at halftime, but Sapre was still watching.
I was watching the match. But whatever. So I'm doing okay. I'm 36th now in the football
league. Fantastic.
Out of, I think, how much we have now? About
300,000
people. 300,000 people. They can only show 247.
Yeah.
App mein kharabi hai.
No. They couldn't support it, so they've asked for backup. The new servers they have to buy.
How did you guys do?
So again, if I can interrupt your FPL talk, because we'll get back to you that. But about Gareth Bale, yeah. Doesn't it feel like that non-move to China from, 2 years ago, is looking worse and worse for everybody involved? For Real Madrid, who are still paying him, and who stopped the move at the nth minute. For Gareth Bale himself, who's Now people are realizing that he's just not a good footballer anymore. And for Tottenham, who have suddenly found them burdened with this guy.
Yeah, but I think Turkey is the new China, so.
So he'll have to probably go there. You think he'll even get a contract? I know he can get paid for one more year at Real Madrid, which is great. Like, good for him. But his football career is over, right? Like, it just seems to be done.
I hope so. I think ended on a good note, scoring the Champions League final. So, I mean, good way to go.
Yeah. And probably if whenever the Euros happen, he'll play that with Wales. Mm-hmm. And then
Daniel James on one wing and Bale on the other. Wow.
Ramsey
in the middle.
Yeah. And Giggs not being there because he's at home, you know, because some whatever.
Those are all the Wales players, you know, na, Sapre.
Anyway, okay, back to FPL. Sapre, what do you do right? You were about to say.
No, I said what I did right. And I just want to check with you.
You just said Captain Son.
Yeah,
and you
all you said is your captain sucked. That's all we got from you.
No, I mean, the other team was better. I put Martinez in goal, hoping that he would get points, and he did. And Antonio was a disappointment for me. Rashford has continued to disappoint me now for a while.
I dropped him like the hot potato.
He dropped him. But yeah, so I'm not as disappointed because a lot of people's captain choices were berserk. So yeah, I think what out of 58 is not bad for this game week. So I'm 30 in the 30s. I'm 36th. I was on 29th, so I fell down 5 points. I feel bad suddenly. Mm. I didn't feel as bad when I was in the hundreds. You know, now I feel bad about it.
But then it was just a blur. Now you think you're actually doing well, even though
hope is not the best thing.
Yeah, especially for United fans.
What about you?
I am terrible. I'm 3 digits, 127.
Okay, very nice. Very, very nice. Karthik, do you want to take up this question?
No, a green mark is there because I scored above average. So I have a green arrow Football Football League. So I would have gone up a few places. But that's fine. But we have football this week as well. And a lot of great matches. Yeah, I mean, I thought we had a break until the weekend. But no.
Define great matches again, Karthik.
Yeah, okay. I think we covered it last week, but there were one or two that were interesting. I think Arsenal Wolves, that's interesting. Okay, may not be great.
Sheffield is playing West Brom for fans of the relegation battle.
So basically, Fulham can push further away from the bottom two clubs. Yeah, that's what you're saying.
But still in the bottom three.
See, let's not get into specifics here, Shivram. It's a 38 match season.
Fair enough. Southampton visit United. How do you think that's going to go down?
That should be fun. Yeah, that should be good fun. Yeah. But although they beat Arsenal in the FA Cup, but then Arsenal really schooled them in the league match. And I think when we were watching Southampton together, was it Saturday when they lost again? They had a couple of goals disallowed. And
against Villa,
Against Aston Villa. Yeah. So I think they're on a 2 or 3 match losing streak. So I think maybe it's a good time to bounce back versus Manchester United.
Why would you say that? I don't know. It's good for United to bounce back against a team who's come back from a loss against Villa. I'm hopeful. I'm an eternal hopeful. The only decent match... Now, I can't even say decent because I've seen how these teams have been playing over the last two game weeks. Tottenham play Chelsea. I mean, that is going to be a terrible match, but that's the only match that is worth... I mean, if Ranveer had to make that ad with, you know, apart from Super Sunday, he had to make an ad, probably those are the only two team logos that would go on that screen.
What is similar between the Tottenham game and Sindhu border? They all have buses parked.
Very nice. Well played. Yeah, but you're right. This does not look very appealing, especially with Harry Kane not being there for a while now.
I think he's left. He's left Tottenham. He's done.
Yeah, he's decided. He just left. Enough is enough. Yeah.
He left at halftime only. He's a kaide nikalo.
Guys, breaking news. Mustafi has left Arsenal.
Arre, that we've known for the last
six
years.
No, that was rumors. It's confirmed.
He's gone to Hertha Berlin, right?
No, Schalke,
yeah. And that Kabak or whatever is coming back to Liverpool. So that's the switch they're trying to get.
Yeah, it's done. It seems to be done at least.
It's not even interesting. How is that breaking news?
Breaking and interesting is Jesse Lingard to West Ham.
You're talking about a World Cup winner, okay? Put some respect to the name of Shrokdan Mustafi.
Skodran.
Yeah. That's what I was going for.
You know what his special move is of Mustafi? Mm-hmm. When he makes a mistake, right? He turns around to his teammates and points at their head saying, use your head, guys.
Hey, which reminds me, why was David Luiz smiling all through that match?
He was really happy to meet his ex-teammates, Cavani. And is there anyone else? No, just Cavani. So Cavani and him go a long way back. Their hair salon, I think, is also the same. So I think they were just exchanging notes and, you know, words they shouldn't be using on their Insta stories and stuff like that.
Tuchel and Chelsea jana ke apne go meet him someday for lunch. Everyone, Thiago is also here. We all are here now.
I think Luis was mostly laughing at United's attack is what was happening. I mean, itna mistake kiya main fir bhi nahi mara tu aisa kaise?
Such a boring. Actually, not boring. The second half was at least decent from an Arsenal standpoint. They at least played well there.
No. Don't sugarcoat it. Yeah, we know what we went.
Hey, Lacazette went closest. So by definition, moral victory is Arsenal. So on aggregate, Arsenal win 1-0 in the league. In the
and without like four or five first team players that you know, Saka, no Oba, so
exactly, yeah. And with their first team players, I mean, they wouldn't even make it to the squad for Arsenal.
True.
And their own first team players don't come on, so like Van de Beek and also.
I don't know. I mean, what are the right matches for Ole to get Van de Beek off the bench?
Carabao Cup.
But he starts.
He can start in Carabao Cup.
At least he could have come when Scott McTominay injured himself. Ki fuck me, ab to Van de Beek ko leke aaya, matlab I'm injuring myself. Phir bhi nahi leke
aaya. He got Marshall. But I think Van de Beek at the start, right? When he didn't play like three games or something and started and play a little. And then there was a stat every time Van de Beek has played, you know, United have won, scored a goal or something for 27 minutes or something like that. Then his agent went and made a noise. Saying, khilana nahi hai toh fir bulaya kyu? So stuff like that. So then I think Ole has taken like it to heart, saying, nahi khilayega, kar le jo karna hai. So I think that has what has gone down. It's my conspiracy theory.
But by that logic, you should have also benched Pogba. But no, he can't. He has no other choice. Matlab, kaun khilega fir?
Khilana hi padega. Arre, Pogba is very good on the ball. Yeah. We've appreciated, in spite of the fact he signed for United and wants to leave, which is the right move. But he's a fantastic player. What a great ball player.
So
also World Cup winner.
Also World Cup winner with Mustafi and Giroud.
Giroud won a World Cup without even hitting the target. So what a talent.
So Chelsea is also now on this Pep Roulet issue. The amount of players that they have, ZH just was not available in the match.
Tuchel has said, I will start afresh.
Correct.
Kal se training mein aao. जो अच्छा करेगा वो खेलेगा और अलोंजो इतनी देर से रेस्ट करके आया है तो अच्छा खेला ट्रेनिंग में एंड देन ही गॉट एंड अलोंजो हैज टू स्कोर अ गोल आई मीन इट्स जस्ट रिटन एवरी टाइम अलोंजो स्टार्ट्स ही विल स्कोर एंड व्हाट अ वंडर गोल
आई थिंक ही हैज अ प्रॉब्लम थॉमस टुचेल हैज अ प्रॉब्लम विद चिलवेल ही आल्सो सब्स्टिट्यूटेड हिम इन द लास्ट मैच
लेगेसी टीम लैम्पार्ड का लेगेसी है ना तो नहीं लेने का चाहिए नहीं खिलाएंगे नहीं कर ले तू उसका प्यार है ना जा उसके साथ जा मैड्रिड
So Chilwell's issue is, so however good he is, I mean, and he's fine, he's a decent player, but if you notice, he keeps playing sideways passes, I feel. And this guy wants his wingbacks to do a lot more, or his fullbacks, not wingbacks. But yeah, I mean, I don't see, I think Chilwell will get a chance, but like, he won't be first choice undisputed like he was under Frank Lampard.
So tell me, for the uninitiated and who don't watch or haven't seen too much of football in France, what is this manager's style of play? Or does he have one?
In France, the PSG team, you can't
play Neymar
really,
is the style.
Yeah. So that's a bit, that'll be a bit unfair on Tuchel also to attribute a style there. I mean, we remember, they're so brilliant on the counter, man. I mean, PSG were absolutely, remember before the Champions League final, we were all like that Bayern and their high line. And to be fair, PSG did have plenty of chances, even in their run-up to the final. But when you play with Neymar, when you play with Di Maria, when you play with Mbappe, I mean, how much of a style can you impose? But usually he comes from this very, I think it's more very much like Pep Guardiola. At least, yeah, it is extremely similar to Pep Guardiola. It won't be your, what do they call it, Shivram? Gegenpressing. No? Like
Gegenpressing.
Yeah, it's not similar to that at all. It's more like how Guardiola plays.
It's just it hope.
What is Spanish for gegenpressing?
Yeah, hope is the only strategy.
My only fear is, you think they've gone and got Tuchel because they're like, acha, we have two German speakers who we spent money on, so we have to get one more German speaker. It's like everyone who talks Hindi, Marathi are friends.
Oh my God, that is a very big accusation. You heard it here first on Football Show. Chelsea got a German manager because they had language issues with it. I mean, Lampard had just not lost the dressing room. He also lost the language. So by definition, Tuchel was a shoo-in. But Karthik, tell me, you're saying allegation number one is that he's fluent in German.
Allegation, and he's fluent in English.
Allegation number two is that he can speak to Werner in both languages. What has Werner done since?
That has been two matches. Now we have to give them a little time.
And so, what will he say to, like, score?
No. So, see, I will not put Werner's performance on him yet. As long as the team is getting results, right? That would be unfair on Tuchel.
When your right-back and left-back have scored two goals?
I mean, you can at least manage till the end of the season and then figure Werner out.
I think the bigger challenge is at least Werner scored some goals. Problem is for him to do something about that other Chelsea, Jesse Lingard type looking player, Kai Havertz. He has not done anything this season. Absolutely nothing.
I just want to give credit back to Karthik. And you heard it here first. On football. There's a lot of firsts that we are referring to today. Karthik called it before Kai Havertz was born, which is, I think, a couple of years back, that Kai Havertz isn't worth his name. And he's possibly being bought to, you know, upsell in 2 years to, I think, some other team. And then he'll play well. And you know how Chelsea is when they sell players. So, you heard it here first, guys. Please tweet to Karthik at footballshootball.
He's currently just not. I mean, I remember when they were talking about him, 100 million player, Germany next big thing. No, he never looked it for not Bayer Leverkusen, not once he looked it. Anyway, why should we pick on only on
pick the Pick on the people Havertz, who wrote those headlines. You're journalistic people.
And you're the
they
one
only
the,
want
and,
you to click.
And you are the one with the blue tick, Karthik, so...
Yeah, you tell us. We'll get you withheld for all you care.
pro tip, in case that happens to anybody and on any account that you want, just go change your location to some other
Karthik,
country.
If you have friends who are that good, just text them. Don't tweet. Right. Like, no one's going to change their location to come look at your tweet.
I mean, I'm sure Vinam is listening to us. And he probably...
Shout out to Vinam for liking everything that Karthik has ever written in his life. I think he went back and liked Karthik's dissertation also.
Hi, Vinam.
But yeah, so what is there anything to look forward to? What happened in that German bakery league?
German bakery league. Are ABC bolte the, phir Pune ho jata.
we can skip. Yeah, everyone did.
We just discussed, Werner and Tuchel. What else is left there?
I don't know. So, nothing really happening. When is the transfer deadline? Is it, what is it, extended
right
time?
Now? Anytime
is
now.
Is 31st now still?
It's 1st of February, but the transfer this time is on 1st. So, that's what I've been telling everyone. Guys, this is the perfect rectangular month. Like, you have to make every minute in this month count. Yeah, it starts on a Monday and it ends on a Saturday. There are only 4 weeks. So,
Sunday,
you look at the
Sunday,
calendar.
Sunday.
It ends on a Sunday, sorry. You look at the calendar, it's a perfect rectangle. There are no gaps in this month.
Yeah,
28
Karthik.
Days divided by 7.
We all have Twitter, Karthik. We've seen the tweet you're referring to. It's fine.
So I'm saying now this month is for everyone to do the best that they can because it's perfect rectangular.
So what happens next month when it's not rectangular?
Oh, f***.
Just give up, guys. We start on a Thursday, end on some Wednesday. Can't do anything. I can't work. Sorry, boss. If you're listening to this, this is not a rectangular month. Sorry. That sounds like a Chelsea excuse.
That sounds like a Chelsea. Mm. We have nothing to look forward to tonight, thankfully. And then we start tomorrow with Sheffield against West Brom for Premier League fans. And some in some Serie A Italian league we don't care about.
If you watch real, like actual credible links, then you won't get that commentary, Sapre. You go to Ronaldo 7 and all. Just pay Hotstar, man, for once. Like, what is your problem?
Why would anybody pay? Why would there even be a credible link to watch Serie A? I still don't get it.
My point is, why would anyone watch?
The moment Ronaldo leaves Juventus, the viewership is anyways going to fall. And French league viewership is going to go up because some rich guy in Barcelona's contract got leaked. I don't know.
Richest guy?
WhatsApp sabka leak ho raha hai aajkal.
WhatsApp agreement bheja kya Messi ne? Please find attach PFA.
PFA to.
How did it get leaked? I think they.
PFA to England.
So there are rumors that Barcelona themselves have leaked it.
That is a good idea. Conspiracy. Yeah. Arey, they go 1.2 billion in debt. His contract is 500 million. Guess where it's where? What does half of 1.2 billion? 600 billion. Yeah, who is responsible? Messi.
But that move is going to happen. Neymar has come out and said, no, things have changed. Now I'm enjoying myself at PSG.
It happens when no other club has any money to buy you.
He saw his contract saying, chal, aadha aadha laga to tik chalega. Main hi Mbappe ko bhi leke aata.
Yeah. But that'll be fun. I mean, but this transfer window has been awful. And it shows the impact that COVID has had on the clubs, because in the Premier League before deadline day, there were just like 3 or 4 permanent signings. There has been no buzz around deadline day as well.
If only January was a rectangular month, I think.
I was hoping would move.
Before that, Sapre, can I ask Sivram something? Because we didn't get to this at all. Mesut Ozil left Arsenal.
I unfollowed him. I don't know what's happening.
I think we missed this in that week, or the week it happened during the week when the cricket was going on. But yeah, anyway. So, I mean, how do you feel about this guy as an Arsenal player? Because even still today, when I picture him, I still think of Real Madrid. Yeah, in all honesty, I don't think of or picture him in an Arsenal jersey at all. But from what I hear, he is beloved. Yeah, Gunners, yeah.
What is that impression? Can you do that again for our listeners?
Isn't that what the
he says? Yeah, Gunners, yeah, yes, you're right. Yeah, but I don't know why you became throaty like Ajay Devgan ka aisa kuch. Some stuff you're... Anyway, but I think he was a fantastic player in his prime. He was once en route to scoring the most number of assists in the league before Giroud blanked for 6 consecutive games. So he has had his contributions. He's won 2 FA Cups with Arsenal. But then he would go missing in the big games. That was a major accusation that he's never really come back from. And then with whatever happened over the last year, I think if everyone's familiar with the Hindi movie called Atithi Tum Kab Jaoge, that is very, very relevant, because at some point in time, he just took over social media. He took over Arsenal's payroll.
Mascot also, no? What is the mascot?
Yeah, so he took over the payroll basically to pay Gunnersaurus. And he was giving back to the community a lot, which is great. But your
primary... Aray, tum log football ne khelne dete ho, toh what else is he supposed to do?
Sign a different... But kaun dega paisa? So he was like cash 22. He was waiting. So the deal behind this is Arsenal pay out a loyalty bonus in September, which is much after the transfer window ends. So he was supposed to get like plus 8 million in that. So why I wouldn't leave. Agar bonus mil raha, tum chhod ke jaoge. Nahi na. So he basically waited for that to happen, and then he was frozen out of the squad, and then he had nothing to do between September to now. So it feels like a long time, also because it was 2020, which is 30 years together. So eventually, when now he's finally left, he's gone to the expected club that we all
Fenerbahce, and he's going to have a great month. I don't know if he's debuted as yet, probably not.
No, so
he's going to have a perfect rectangular month in Turkey.
He was on the bench here, like he was not in the squad here, he was not in the squad there. So, I mean, it's not nothing much has changed over the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, Sapre, you wanted to discuss other transfers. I hope you know them, because I don't know.
I was hoping for these 3-4 players to move. One was Christian Eriksen, so I don't think he's moving, or is he?
But he's playing extremely well in the last 3 games. He's suddenly become this deep-lying playmaker from where he became that God only knows. And now Conte loves him.
He was waiting for February.
Yeah, my God, it's stunning. It's only been 2 weeks, yeah, which is about 3 or 4 games at max. Yeah. But Eriksen is proving to be a star for Inter suddenly.
That is how long it takes for us to find Arsenal stars. 2 weeks is more. They're already.
I think what you're saying is he was linked to Arsenal and then he decided no,
I'd rather play here. So they go there. I mean, why would you go to Arsenal, right? After you played for Spurs, you've already seen no trophy for forever. So join another club which has seen it for lesser time, but still no trophy. FA Cup bhi nahi jeetenge is saal, so the bacha kya hai?
So talking about people not wanting to go to Arsenal because they've played at Spurs, Dele Alli, he's not moving either.
Hey, who is the Dele Alli? Firstly,
Dele Alli only, no? What is he?
Aray, he's like Delhi wala Ali.
Oh, Dele Alli. Dele Alli. What is he? Dele Alli. Dele Alli only.
Dele Alli, man. Come on, get your pronunciation right.
People who can't get a game, Dele Alli only. What is happening? Is he moving? Is Mourinho? Abhi to khila usko, matlab Kane's also injured, right? He'll still not play. What? He'll play some Vinicius. And Vinicius
bought as a backup striker. So when Kane goes out, he plays Vinicius. I mean, what's wrong with that? You just want to hate Mourinho for the fact that he's not worth anything. I agree, but don't hate him.
That is also true. And last but not the least, what's happening with Lucas Torreira?
No idea, man.
He's staying at Atletico for the rest of the season.
He's going to take over Atletico social media.
I mean, the most thrilling news that's come out of today is Joshua King, if you remember, from Bournemouth, has been offered to Southampton for Shane Long. And he said, "Meko utna hi paisa chahiye jitna I used to get in when I was in the Premier League," and they're saying no. And Shane Long looks like he wants to go, which is understandable.
Shane Long wants to stop playing, I think. He's just been playing for a long time. He's just tired. Abhi to bitha do, yaar, matlab.
Sapre, I was saying this is the most thrilling news in irony, like sarcasm.
Ah.
But you started giving gyan on top of that.
sorry.
So, I mean, that's the you are our Ozil. Yeah, Gunners, yeah.
Chalo, theek hai. I think that's about it. Enjoy football. There's no Super Sunday this week, or maybe there is.
There is, Baba. There are games on the weekend also.
Is there a Super Sunday? Like, don't tell me West Ham versus Liverpool.
West Ham versus...
This is a genuine Super Sunday.
There is a Super Sunday. How dare you say there's not a Super Sunday? I will tell you in 1 second, once my... Liverpool play Man City. How dare you, Sapre? It's the top of the table versus third place team playing on the weekend. They might change, obviously, in the middle.
Chalo, let's hope for a draw. Score draw.
Quick predictions, yeah? Quick predictions.
Liverpool are at home, so just so you are prepared in your prediction.
I'm going City. I can't look past them winning 2-0. Or 1-0 because they're not putting teams away, as Shivram said. So 2-1, chalo.
Decide in your head. 2-1. All of this should 2-1. Be in your head, not on your podcast.
2-1. 2-1 to City.
Sabri? I am going with 2-0 to Pool.
Oh, wow. Very polarizing. I am going with 3-1 to City.
Ooh, okay.
So one of us will be right.
Yeah, one of us will be right. At least in the teams that we pick. So fair enough.
Correct.
Cool.
Yeah, unless it's a draw, of course, then all of us are wrong.
Correct. Which is very likely. Yeah. Which is very, very likely.
I don't think it'll draw, because a draw would give advantage to United, and I don't think both teams would want to do that. Given the genuine title.
Let's end the podcast on a low then. Before we head into February.
Yes. No, these are PRK side effects, like I said. And on this end note, there is a quote from Carl Jung. If you don't know him, he used to stay right in Antopil here next to us.
Carl Jung.
A few years ago. Carl Jung. He said that the word happy would lose its meaning if it were not balanced by sadness. All of us are trying to find the balance, but there's too much sad inclination right now happening with this club that I
support. When I was in MBA college, and whenever I go to San Francisco, you have to start with a quote. Like, it is, otherwise they'll deport you. So it's like this only. You're worse than an MBA student.
So what? You walk up there into immigration and you're like, a friend in need is a friend in need. Hi, I'm Subram King. Those are my papers. Is that what?
Karthik, the next time I go to the US, let me pay for your ticket, because that doesn't fly. Then what happens is, then they say, pagal hai tu wapas ja. They send you back after that. So then you get one more flight, and then you have to pay for your own deportation also. So
bad.
It's not free.
That's too
ask Kamilaj. Ask Kamilaj.
So we will take your advice, Shivram. And yeah, that's about it. We'll see you again very soon, probably next week, with a lot more. I think we have 2 game weeks gone by till the next episode.
Yeah, 2 games. It starts tomorrow night and one on the weekend.
Fantastic. No sleep, work is suffering, but who cares, because we love football. And
FPL points count more than money.
On that note, we'll see you. Thank you, guys.
So if you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on our social media handles. We are at IVM Podcast on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I'm Fickleberry Hun on Twitter and Instagram. That's Huckleberry Finn, but Fickle.
If you want to reach out to me, I am Sapre on Twitter and G Sapre on Instagram.
You can reach out to me at iRant, which is IYERANT on Twitter and Instagram. This is Football. Football, recognize.
Working Monday to Friday, glued to your chair, making you feel dull? Worry not. Get your 5-minute weekly dose of travel around the world with Postcards from Nowhere. Join me every Thursday as I explore the strange, obscure, and fascinating parts of the world and bring out facets of travel you may not have thought of before. You can find us on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Namaskar, dear friends. My name is Ashish Vidyarthi. Life, as you know, is a journey. And you and I, travelers, how can we celebrate this travel? I have a podcast for you, Begin the Journey. I share stories and moments from my life. Do tune in every Monday and Thursday to listen to my podcast on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcast from. Cheers.